Hey everyone, it's Lena here, and in this short video, I'm excited to show you how easy it is to control Ableton Live with KeyLab Essential. Let's dive in. Ableton Live comes with a dedicated KeyLab Essential MIDI script, which allows it to be recognized instantly after launching it alongside your DAW. However, it's good to make sure to use the latest DAW versions to ensure the best KeyLab Essential integration experience. Normally, with the latest DAW version, you won't need to dive deep into the menu to set it up, as it's done automatically when you launch your DAW. Let's start with the main encoder. The main encoder is used to navigate through different scenes in Ableton Live. Simply turn the encoder to move between scenes. Clicking the main encoder will launch the entire scene, triggering all the clips within it. Next, we have knobs 1 to 8. These knobs have dual functionality. In device mode, they control various parameters of the currently focused plugin. To adjust the parameter, simply turn the corresponding knob. This allows you to shape your sound while interacting with the instrument. Additionally, in mixer mode, these knobs control the panning of the focus track. Turn the knobs to adjust the panning position with ease. Moving on to faders 1 to 8. In device mode, these faders control the parameters of the plugin on the selected track. Simply slide the faders up or down to adjust the parameter values. In mixer mode, these faders control the volume of the selected track. Slide the faders to control the volume level. Knob 9 and fader 9 have dedicated functions. They control both the volume and panning of the selected track. Use knob 9 to adjust the panning position and fader 9 to control the volume level. Let's now explore the contextual buttons. Contextual button number 1 toggles between device and mixer control modes. Use this button to switch between controlling the devices such as effects or instruments and the mixer. Contextual button number 2 is used to arm or disarm the selected track for recording. Press this button to enable or disable recording on the selected track. Contextual buttons number 3 and 4, on the other hand, are used to navigate to the previous and next tracks, respectively. Moving on to the transport section, we have the play, stop, record, and loop buttons. These buttons are self-explanatory and allow you to control the playback and recording of your music. Now, let's talk about the pads. In Bank A mode, the pads are assigned to trigger clips in the scene view. Each pad corresponds to a specific clip, and the Bank A LED color matches the color of the selected clip. In Bank B mode, the pads are used to trigger sounds. The pads are mapped in this way so they trigger sounds in the native drum machine instrument from Live. If you're using Analog Lab in your DAW, it's important to ensure that the correct device is linked when you open the plugin. To have full control over Analog Lab, you can enter Analog Lab mode by selecting the Arturia program using the Prog button. When Analog Lab is selected, you can manage the plugin just like you would in standalone mode, including navigation selection and macros control. And that's it! Hopefully this video showed you just how easy and enjoyable it is to make music using KeyLab Essential with Ableton Live. For more detailed information on KeyLab Essential and how to use it, make sure to watch our dedicated video series on our channel. Thanks for watching and see you soon.